Opportunity comes but once, opportunity comes but once. But does opportunity really come once in a lifetime? Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. Today it's Dara D here. My name is Dara, Oluwa Dara Simio Dejae, Dara D for short. And you're welcome back to my channel today. Today is a beautiful day. Today is gonna be a beautiful day for you. Recently, I think it was last week that this topic came and I was like, let me talk about it. Because even personally, this thing has affected me a lot. The fact that we keep using this word, opportunity comes but once. Now, I'm not saying that when you see an opportunity, you should not seize that opportunity. That's not what I'm saying. But this saying has actually led to a lot of troubles. It has put people in a lot of problem. Now, take for example, somebody is doing sales, or you've always wanted to get a particular type of human hair, or you've always wanted to get a particular type of car, and the person is doing sales now and the person is selling it way cheaper. It is an opportunity, right? It's an opportunity to get that particular thing, but you don't have the money. Like, you don't have this money, you cannot afford it. But because you feel like this is an opportunity, opportunity comes but once, then you decide to go from one place to another just to find and make sure that you can get this thing. And at the end of the day, you get it, then what? You see, God created us, his children, to have dominion over material things, over the things of the earth, over everything that he has created. And it is funny because at the end of the day, we allow these things to control us, then we forget that, wait though, I'm actually the one that should decide, okay, I have the money but I don't even want to buy this thing. Do you understand? Or I don't have the money, so why would I now keep going from one person to another to get this money? Now, this particular topic is very, very critical in the sense that it can go in different ways, but there's a particular way that I am talking about today. It is not a broad thing in quotes, because people have seized their opportunity and it has taken them places in life. That is not what I'm talking about. I'm talking about some opportunities that you know that you are taking but you don't need them, but you just keep pushing yourself. You keep pushing yourself and you keep telling yourself opportunities come but once. Now look at this. You know, they have been telling you that accept Jesus into your life, or Jesus the same yesterday, today and forever, or give your life to Christ. That is an opportunity too, but you're like, later. You can push that one. But when it comes to material things, then that is when your head or your flashlight is on like this. Oh my God, I don't want this to pass me by. I want to do this fast. When you seize an opportunity, you seize it. When you see something, it means you are in control of that thing now. So even when you seize an opportunity, you are seizing it because you are taking the opportunity, and the opportunity is still not controlling you. If you cannot control the opportunity that you have, if one opportunity is over your control, then do not go for that opportunity. If that hair you want to buy is more than you can afford, do not go for it. If that job you want to apply for, if they are telling you to come and do one thing, change figures, or do some things that you cannot control, that is against God's perfect plan for you, that is against everything that has to do with God, then do not take it. You see, sometimes some things we call great opportunities are actually not great opportunities compared to the other opportunities that are actually coming. You see, last year I used to sometimes check Instagram and I see people doing sales, and they will say things like, this is our last sales for the year, or if you don't buy this now you're out, or stuff like my sister, if you don't buy this now this will be our cheapest sales ever. And you just see the person again in 2 months time coming with cheaper prices and you're like, now wow. So when you were saying that the last one was going to be your cheapest sale for the year, so what happened? So what I'm telling you is that don't allow stuff like this to push you. If you can afford it, afford it. If you cannot afford it, just calm down. You see, there are great things that are coming your way, great opportunities. Don't push yourself. If you cannot seize an opportunity, control an opportunity, do not take that opportunity. Now guys, believe this. Every opportunity that requires you to do a bad thing, every opportunity that seems great but requires you to do a bad thing, is actually not a great opportunity. There are other opportunities, bigger opportunities that are coming your way. Don't worry. If one opportunity opens door and requires you to backslide, requires you to lose your self-esteem, requires you to do all those things that are contrary to God's plan for your life, then it is not your opportunity. So just chill, chill, relax, and calm down. Your own opportunity is coming, and when your opportunity comes, it will be at the right time, because it makes everything beautiful in its time. So when it is your particular time, when it is God's time for you, you would know, and the Holy Spirit is going to guide you. So guys, when it comes to opportunities, if you know your God, if you have your God, if you know your value, if you know what to do and how to do it, you see opportunities, forget it. Opportunities will not come to you once in a lifetime. Opportunities will keep coming. You would open your doors and opportunities will come through your door in different sizes, like these big opportunities. So don't worry. So guys, opportunity never comes just once. Opportunity will come again. Opportunities might be lost, but they will come again, knocking on your door again and again and again. So please, I beg you, in God's name, don't stand on that word too much and affect other aspects of your life. Don't stand on that word too much and affect every other critical aspect of your life. Don't stand on that word too much and affect your spiritual part and every other part of your life. And most importantly, guys, I've said it before, that God created us to have dominion. Before you can have dominion, if you don't have self-control, then there's nothing like you dominating your carnal mind or whatever it is that wants a particular thing. So you should be able to control yourself. Sometimes you have to think. And think if you really need some of these opportunities. And think if you really need to do that thing. That's like, if you don't do it, okay. Just weigh your options according to the Spirit of God. And I pray the Lord will help you in Jesus' name. Thank you guys for watching my video. Please don't forget to like, to share, and to subscribe. And if you are new here, please subscribe to this channel. God bless you. Thank you so much. I'll see you in my next video. Bye.